Hi, welcome to your carrier update brought to you by PowerFleet. I'm Mike Vincent. He's Zach Strickland. Let's dig in, man.
Yeah, let's dig in. Really fascinating stuff about the AB5 thing, and especially with all the stuff happening in California.
Oh, my gosh.
The freight.
Yeah.
There's lots of freight there.
Is there?
Yeah, there's lots of freight there.
Prove it.
All right, so let's start off with the national tender rejection indexes of with reefer here in purple, 36%, 36.2%, coming up a little bit after lulling after the holiday. Flatbed, the Anthony Index, flatbed outbound tender rejection rates jumping back, actually pulling back down to about 22%.
Yeah, all the way down.
Yeah, all the way down to 22%. And the Van National Tender Rejection Index there at 21.84%. So, very different directions here. You got reefer coming up, the flatbed going down, van kind of middling.
Sideways-ish.
Sideways-ish, if you will. So let's go ahead and jump into the next piece here with the spot rates. Mm-hmm. And we see spot rates bouncing for reefer and van coming out of the holiday week. You had a little bit of a lull. This is a real strong retraction after the holiday.
Well, it was a pretty good correction, I guess.
Yeah, it's still kind of mysterious to me that it went that far.
Yeah.
I mean, we always expect it to come down a little bit, but I think the overriding trend works well for both van and reefer here. Mm-hmm. You know, whatever happened that week, I think you can just see, rates still kind of easing off the holiday period, still extremely high, $4.21 for reefer, and of course, right around $3.50 for both flatbed and van spot rates on the national average. Flatbed coming down after moving in the opposite direction of the other two, you know, but still.
Yeah, during that week.
Yeah, we're right around where we were with flatbed. It's been slowly edging down. It's same as it was a month ago, if you will.
It's got a slight downward run to it, but that's where we're at.
And van and reefer, similar situation, kind of easing coming out of that. So let's look at the week over week changes with our map next. Where in the country we're seeing some of the biggest ups and downs. We see not a lot of blues here. That means that those are the tightening markets. Anything in the reds or oranges, that is the loosening markets. We're seeing more orangish red than we are blue on this map, especially in some of these larger markets such as Allentown, Indianapolis, Ontario, and then all over California and the West Coast region out there in Nevada also.
Loosening capacity in these areas, relative. It's not loose, but it's loosening.
Well, you can almost draw a line here through the country, you know, this corridor right here, just seeing them, you know, and it's almost like, they're kind of pulling out into these two areas. And this is, of course, the consummate destination. And the consummate origin.
That's exactly right.
I'm not super shocked about seeing the Northeast showing some easing week over week.
No.
But I am a little shocked at seeing Ontario and
there's more capacity getting out there than demand for it, even though demand is really, really high. And that's why you're saying you're a little shocked.
Yeah.
Capacity was able to outstrip demand there.
Well, normally you see one or the other, not both.
Right, not both.
And then the Southeast, relatively quiet, right on par with where it was last week.
Yep, right where
not a lot of change. And then the lone dark blue market up there in Pendleton, Oregon. So let's look at some of these. Let's look at the next chart. See some of these loosening markets. Ontario, Columbus, Allentown, Indianapolis, all shown here. When I say easing, I don't mean that it's easing and all of a sudden there's trucks everywhere.
Yeah.
No. They're just coming down. We're still seeing this kind of retraction out of a holiday period. You know, Indianapolis here, really not easing significantly.
Not really, and they were taking off since the end of July, mid-July.
So week over week, we've got a dip. But the overriding trend, it still looks like it's elevated. Now, the rest of them, they all look like they're just kind of normalizing and coming back to where they were about early August-ish.
Mm-hmm.
In Ontario, there's easing here, but there's not a lot of movement there, really.
No,
it's still really 17% it's rejection rates.
Yeah.
And let's look at the lone blue market here in Pendleton, Oregon. I've got a reefer rejection rate for Pendleton here in green, and the van rejection rate here in blue. Very disparate experience here if you are operating.
Yeah, but both going in the same direction right now, right?
Yeah. It is something to note that van rejection rates are coming up as well. But 63% rejection rate for reefer.
That's crazy, man.
Yeah. That's so definitely tighter conditions.
And that's not even the worst.
No. Well, back in March, that was when the rest of the market was really surging. Reefer rejection rates hit all-time highs around national average around 50%.
Yeah.
So one out of every two loads on the contracted reefer side getting rejected.
Right.
Not still having trouble in Pendleton.
Well, I mean, this time of year, these markets that are not incredibly large and have some distance to them, right? It's not like the Northeast where all crowded, but they become very, very interactive at this point in the season, right? In this fallish, getting into fall, where they really start to interact and make spikes like that start to happen.
A lot of volatility.
Yeah, a lot of volatility up there this time of year. Thanks so much, Zach.